हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू दी क्लास। आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम। टुडे विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट लिंकेज एंड रिकॉम्बिनेशन। एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्क्राइब्ड, एज लिंकेज कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द फिजिकल एसोसिएशन बिटवीन द जीन्स ऑन अ क्रोमोसोम, वेयर इज रिकॉम्बिनेशन कैन बी टर्म्ड एज द जनरेशन ऑफ नॉन पेरेंटल जीन कॉम्बिनेशन from the parental ones. So we'll begin with linkage and recombination. Morgan carried out several dihybrid crosses in Drosophila to study genes that were sex linked. The crosses were similar to the dihybrid cross that were carried out by the Gregor Mendel in peas. For example, Morgan hybridized yellow-bodied white-eyed female with the brown-bodied red-eyed males, and then he intercrossed the F1 progeny. To his surprise, he observed that the genes did not segregate independently of each other, and the F2 ratio deviated very significantly from the 9:3:3:1, which was obtained in the dihybrid cross by Mendel. Morgan knew that the genes were located on the X chromosome and quickly observed that two genes in a dihybrid cross were situated on the same chromosome. The proportion of parental gene combination were very much higher than the non-parental type. When the proportion was analyzed of the progeny, the proportion of parental genes were very much higher compared to the non-parental type, that is the recombinant ones. Thomas Hunt Morgan attributed this due to the physical association or linkage of the two genes and coined the term linkage. Why this recombination rate is low? Because he concluded that this may be due to the physical association between two genes. Let us take a simple example which I have also given you earlier. Suppose there is a gene A, gene C and a gene B. Gene A and C are located at a distance of 5 centimorgan, whereas gene C and B are located at a distance of 20 centimorgan. Since these are located very close to each other, the chances of recombination between A and C is less, and the chances of linkage or transmission of these two genes together is high. Similarly, in case of C and B, since the distance between C and B is more, there are more chances of recombination occurring in between, and these genes are less likely to be transferred together. So I hope this linkage concept is clear to you. What defines a linkage? It is to describe the physical association of genes on a chromosome. How much the two genes are close to each other or apart to each other will determine their linkage. What is recombination? Recombination is to describe the generation of non-parental gene recombinations. He also found that some genes were tightly linked while the others were loosely linked. Tightly linked means this gene A and C are very much close to each other, so there are almost 90% chances that in every case of segregation, these two genes will move together, and there are less chances of C and B moving together. So A and C are tightly linked, whereas C and B are loosely linked to one another. For example, white and yellow were very tightly linked and showed only 1.3% recombination. So suppose if this A is for yellow and this C is for white color, so they both are very tightly linked and the rate of recombination between them is only 1.3%. While the white and the yellow, chances of white and yellow to move together are high, as I said. White and miniature wing showed 37.2% recombination. Suppose this C is for white and this is for miniature. So there are more chances of recombination between C and B genes during crossing over in meiosis. So they are loosely linked to each other and the linkage is loose and the recombination rate is high between C and B. A student of Thomas Hunt Morgan, named as Alfred Stewartwent, used the frequency of recombination between gene pairs on the same chromosome as a measure of the distance between genes and mapped their position on the chromosome. As you know that chromosome has two arms, P arm and Q arm, short arm, long arm. So he used this frequency of recombination to measure the distance between two genes and then map their position on a chromosome. Such maps were called as genetic maps, and the distance between the two genes on the genetic map is represented by Senti Morgan. Similarly, again this example, suppose this is a chromosome. In chromosome we have identified three genes, that is gene A, C and B. Depending on the distance between A, B and C, they were located on the chromosome and they were mapped. This is called as the genetic map of, say for example, chromosome number 1. So the distance between A and C is 5 Senti Morgan. The rate of recombination, suppose there is 1% recombination between A and C, so the distance between A and C gene will be 1 Senti Morgan. So if A and C is apart from each other by 5 Senti Morgan, then the chances of recombination between these two genes is 5%. Similar example, 1% recombination, that is the distance between gene will be 1 Senti Morgan. Maximum recombination rate that could be possible is up to 50%. More than 50% chances of recombination are not possible. Genetic maps are used in the sequencing of whole genome as was done in the Human Genome Sequencing Project. This Human Genome Sequencing Project was launched in 1995 and will study in detail about Human Genome Project in the upcoming chapters. Similar example has been provided in your book. This is parental generation, which shows that in cross A, Y and W genes are very closely related to each other and are linked to each other tightly. Whereas in cross B, it suggests that the W and the M gene, that is for white and miniature, are very far apart from each other and are loosely linked with one another. So in the F2 generation, the rate of recombination is 1.3% only in case of the genes that are tightly linked, whereas the rate of recombination is 37.2% in case of genes that are loosely linked. So this diagram just suggests that the genes which are tightly linked to one another, the rate of recombination is very less in those genes as compared to genes that are loosely linked to one another. Okay. Next, we'll be studying about sex determination. The mechanism of sex determination has always been a puzzle for the geneticists. The initial clue about genetic chromosomal mechanism of sex determination can be traced back to some experiments that were carried out in insects. In fact, the cytological observations made in the number of insects led to the development of concept of genetic chromosomal basis of sex determination. Hacking in 1891 could trace a specific nuclear structures all through spermatogenesis in few insects, and it was observed that 50% of the sperm received this structure after spermatogenesis, whereas the other 50% did not receive it. Hacking they gave this structure named as X body. Further investigations by the other scientists led to the conclusion that the X body of Hacking was in fact a chromosome. That is why it was given the name as X chromosome. A large number of insects, the mechanism of sex determination is of the XO type, that is, all eggs bear an additional X chromosome besides the other chromosome, that is the autosome. As you all know, there are 23 pairs of chromosomes that are found in humans. Out of that, 22 pairs of chromosomes are called as autosomes. They do not contribute to the formation of gametes, whereas the remaining 23rd pair of chromosome is called as the sex chromosome, which may be heterogametic or homogametic depending on the phenotype of an individual, whether it is a male or a female. Besides, on the other hand, some of the sperm bear the X chromosome, whereas some do not. Eggs fertilized by ovum having an X chromosome become female, and those fertilized by the sperms that do not have an X chromosome becomes a male. Due to the involvement of the X chromosome in determination of sex, it was designated to be the sex chromosome, and the rest of the chromosome were named as autosome. As I told you earlier, those chromosomes, that is the 23rd pair of chromosome that is involved in 23rd pair of chromosome that is in chromosome that is involved in determination of sex was called as sex chromosome, and the other 22 pairs were called as autosome. Grasshopper is an example of the XO type of sex determination, in which males have only one X chromosome besides the autosome, while the females have a pair of X chromosomes. These observations led to the investigation of a number of species to understand the mechanism of sex determination. In a number of other insects and mammals, including men, XY type of determination is seen, where both male and female have same number of chromosomes. In male, X chromosome is present, but its counterpart is distinctly small and called as Y chromosome. Females have a pair of X chromosome. So the genotype of male's X chromosome is XY, whereas the genotype of female's X chromosome is XX. In humans and Drosophila, both male and female have the same number of chromosomes. Males have 22 autosomes plus the X and Y chromosome. Females have 22 autosomes plus XX chromosome. In the above discussion, we have studied two types of sex determining mechanism. One is the XO type and the other one is the XY type. In both the cases, male produce two types of gametes, either with or without the X chromosome, with or without the X chromosome. Some gametes with X and some with Y. Some with X and some with Y type. Such type of mechanism is designated as to be the example of male heterogamety. Means male produces different types of gametes, that is called as male heterogamety. Now in case of birds, total number of chromosome is same in both males and females. But the difference is heterogamety is shown by the females and not by the male, and hence it is called as female heterogamety. In these organisms, females have one Z and one W chromosome, while males have a pair of Z chromosome besides autosome. So in case of birds, male will have two Z chromosome, female will have one Z and one W chromosome. So female heterogamety is shown in case of birds. The sex determination mechanism in the human is XY type. Out of 23 pairs of chromosome present, 22 pairs are exactly same in both males and females, whereas the presence of an X and Y chromosome are determinant of the male characteristic. During spermatogenesis, among males, two types of gametes are produced. 50% of the total gamete produce the X chromosome, and the rest 50% produce 50% produce X, and the 50% produce Y chromosome besides autosomes. Females, however, produce only one type of ovum with both the X chromosome. There is an equal probability of fertilization of an ovum with the sperm carrying either X or Y. Now see, this is 22 pair of autosome with XX female ovum, and this is 22 pair of autosome with XY male sperm. When mating or coitus occur, one X chromosome from female and one X chromosome from male can produce a female, that is a girl child. Similarly, when an X chromosome from female and a Y chromosome from male results in fusion and produce a diploid zygote, this results into a boy child. Thus, it is evident that it is the genetic makeup of the sperm that determines the sex of a child. In each pregnancy, there is always a 50% probability of either a male or a female child. Since these two segregate independently, there are 50% chance of fusion of X with X and 50% chance of fusion of X with Y. So now you can say that how sex determination in birds is different from humans. You can say that in case of birds, as we have already studied, that female possesses the heterogametic nature. So the sex of the child will depend on the fusion of which allele or which chromosome of female fuses with the male, that will result in either a male bird or a female bird.